topic of presentation is precancer solutions of cervix. Women's health, as you know, it is vulnerable to various health hazards, and she needs timely awareness and treatment. And we know that women usually pay least importance to her health. Her botheration is usually the health of her family members, children and all. And even though the women's reproductive health directly reflects the health of the nation. And we know that cervical cancer is one of the most common genital tract malignancy among females in India. And human papilloma viral infection is identified as an essential cause of cervical cancer. Epidemiological and laboratory evidence has revealed the human papilloma virus as a major etiological agent for cervical cancer. And high-risk HPV DNA is detected in more than 99% of cervical cancer specimens. And you see, cervical cancer is preventable. Still, it remains a major cause of mortality, morbidity, and premature death of middle-aged women. And you see the disease burden. India represents 26.45% of women dying of cervical cancer. And here is the HPV prevalence. Worldwide, India and in Kerala, here you can see it is the studies on, I got 2012 studies. Human papilloma viruses are members of a large family of virus known as papillomaviridae. They are small, non-enveloped, double-stranded DNA tumor viruses with an icosahedral capsid constituted by 72 capsomeres. This human papilloma virus infects the basal cells of differentiating squamous epithelium of cervix and mucous membrane. The close association between human papilloma virus and cervical cancer was first made by a German virologist, Harald Suhrhusen, who later won Nobel Prize in 2008. And screening of this precancerous lesions has reduced the incidence of cervical cancer, especially in developing countries like US. Early detection of cervical cancer is possible using colposcopy, pap smear test, and HPV DNA testing. And colposcope. Colposcope is an optical device used to visualize the transformation or this transformation zone of cervix where carcinogenesis starts. We'll get 40 to 600 times magnification of this portion, squamocolumnar junction, using this colposcope. And it is the gold standard for diagnosing the precancerous lesions. And colposcopy-directed biopsies are often considered 100% accurate. Here you can see the picture of uterus. Cervix is the lowermost portion of the uterus with length of 3.5 to 4 centimeter and diameter of 2.5 centimeter. And in the middle is the endocervical canal. This endocervical canal is lined by a single layer of columnar epithelium, while this ectocervix, here you can see it is pinkish in color. It is composed of stratified squamous epithelium. Endocervix is reddish in color because of the underlying vasculature. It is composed of single layer of columnar epithelium. And normally in a woman's life, this columnar epithelium is replaced by squamous epithelium. And this phenomenon is called squamous metaplasia. And HPV, human papilloma virus, infects this basal cell of this squamocolumnar junction, and carcinogenesis starts here. In colposcopic procedure, after taking aseptic precautions, we smear this cervix using saline solution so as to clear the mucus and also to visualize the underlying vasculature using the green filter of colposcope. After that, we will smear the cervix using 3 to 5% acetic acid. On smearing this area using acetic acid, in presence of cancerous cells, we can see dense acetovite areas. It is because of the coagulation of this nucleoproteins and cytokines of this cancerous cells with acetic acid. And this is a reversible reaction. This reaction lasts only for 1 minute. And after that, we'll smear the area using this Luger's iodine. This test is the same test that we studied in our school days. That is, the squamous epithelium is abundant in glycogen. And this cancerous cells contain little or no glycogen. On smearing with Luger's iodine, the healthy cells uptake iodine, and we can see the this area is a brown color, mahogany brown color, and iodine negative areas if there is cancerous cells. And depending on this thickness involved, various grades are given for precancerous lesions as CIN1, CIN2, and CIN3. CIN lesions are this precancerous lesions. This invasive cervical cancer is preceded by a long phase of pre-invasive disease, which is collectively called cervical intraepithelial neoplasia. It is characterized microscopically as a spectrum of events progressing from cellular atypia to various grades of dysplasia. And it takes 15 to 20 years for the initial infection to become dysplastic and later invasive cancer. Next is the pap smear test. This is the most widely adopted test for screening human papilloma viral infection and cervical cancer. Here also, the cells are collected from squamocolumnar junction using a wooden spatula and is visualized under microscope to see the carcinogenesis. And this presence of coelocyte is the typical feature of HPV infection. The coelocytes are particular cells, and this cell shows halos around the nucleus with condensation of cytoplasm. And on examining the cells under microscope, we can see the dyskaryosis or carcinogenesis like this: disproportionate nuclear enlargement, irregularity of nuclear outline, abnormality of nucleus in number, size and shape, hyperchromasia, condensation of chromatin material, and multinucleation. Next is HPV DNA testing. It is usually carried out using PCR or polymerase chain reaction and Digene hybrid capture 2 HPV DNA test. This DNA testing is available only in very few centers. So the most widely used techniques for early diagnosis are colposcopy and pap smear. And let us see how this HPV infection is managed by modern people. Currently, there is no effective medical management for HPV infection. And in most of the cases, they use the surgical procedures like LEAP, cryotherapy, electrocauterization, and ablation. And inappropriate use of these surgical procedures can cause unnecessary tissue destruction and loss. And as a preventive measure, they prefer vaccines. 3 vaccines are available in the trade name Cervarix and Gardasil. And 3 types of HPV vaccines are there: bivalent HPV vaccine, quadrivalent HPV vaccine, and nonavalent HPV vaccine. You see, these vaccines, more than 200 types of viral strains are identified till date, and these vaccines covers only 9 strains of viruses. Moreover, these vaccines are administered in girls in between 9 years and women of 26 years. These vaccines are expensive and are not free of side effects. And this human papilloma virus, you know, the pelvic inflammatory disease, it is an inflammatory condition of female genital tract. This and human papilloma virus is one of the pathogen causing this pelvic inflammatory disease. This organism gain entry into the glands of endocervix and produce acute inflammatory changes. And studies have identified PID as a risk factor of cervical cancer. And CDC has recently added invasive cervical cancer to the list of case-defining diseases and also included PID in the classification system. So a strong relation is there between pelvic inflammatory disease and cervical cancer. Often women approach us with complaining of this lower abdominal pain, dyspareunia, dysmenorrhea, etc., signs and symptoms of PID. And you see, the studies have proved that the inflammatory response triggered by bacterial and viral infection as a major risk factor for carcinogenesis. And this carcinogenesis starts from the sites of infection, chronic irritation, and inflammation. Tumor microenvironment composed of inflammation cells are the most important factor in neoplastic process promoting this survival and migration. So you see, this inflammatory response triggered by bacterial and viral infection is said as a causative factor for cervical cancer. Here you can see the signs and symptoms of cervical cancer as intermenstrual bleeding, menorrhagia, postcoital bleeding, increased vaginal discharge, dyspareunia, postmenopausal bleeding, and unexplained or persistent pelvic or back pain. When we analyze these signs and symptoms, it stands very close to the gynec condition said in our classics Pariplutha. You see, Ayurvedic way of diagnosis, differential diagnosis, this prognosis, therapeutics, etc. are very different from modern medicine. It is purely based on the doctrine of Tridosha. And this diseases and Tridosha Visheshan are not separable. And this Pariplutha, in Ayurveda, the gynecological disorders are included under the heading Yoni Vyapath by Brihatrayi, Sushruta, Charaka, and Vagpada. And this Pariplutha is an inflammatory condition with Vada Pitta predominance characterized by dysmenorrhea, dyspareunia, abnormal vaginal discharges, and abnormal bleeding. And this is a pathological condition that affects uterus and adnexa. Whenever we see these patients with HPV infection or detailed history taking, you can see that the main doshas vitiated here is Vata and Pitta. And this simultaneously, this doshas vitiates doshas Rasa, Rakta, Mamsa, and Artava. As this doshas are composed of srodhasis, simultaneous vitiation of srodhasis also takes place. Like Rasavaha Srododushti, Raktavaha Srododushti, Mamsavaha Srododushti, and Arthavaha Srododushti. Garbhashaya is in Vadasthana. So chance for Vata vitiation is more in Yoni Vyapath. And here in this condition, the Sthana Samsaya takes place in Garbhashaya, Gala, or uterine cervix. Due to this malnutrition or Ubavasa, Nisha Jagarana, and mental factors like fee shoga, etc., Vata gets vitiated. And also, there's too much intake of kadu amla rasa pradhana ahara. That is, too much intake of curd, pickles, paneer, etc., vitiates pitta. And because of ashray-ashray bandha, there is vitiation of recta also, and this pitta and vata gets vitiated, and as a result there will be agni madhya and ama formation. As this srotasis, these doshas are composed of srotasis, with the vitiation of dhatu drushti there will be corresponding srodho drushti. And I told you that here in this entity sthana samshaya takes place in uterus, in cervix, and here you see the vyadhikshamatva becomes less, and this organisms like human papilloma virus gains easy entry into the cervix, and this later carcinogenesis takes place. And initially this patient shows signs and symptoms of pariploida, and if we are not treating it properly it becomes chronic, and three doshas gets vitiated, and it becomes asadhya, or it becomes cervical carcinoma. And in ashtanga hridaya, while detailing the complications of yoni vyapat, acharya clearly states that idi yonigada nari ehi shuklam na pradichati tato garbham na grindadi rogamscha apnodi daruna asrudhara arsho gulmadi abadamscha aniladivihi. So if yoni rogas are not treated properly, it will result in infertility and other daruna vyadhis or malignancies, and pariploida is a clear example of such condition. If pariploida is not treated properly, it can cause this carcinomatous changes and can lead to cervical cancer. Passage of centuries has led to the development of new diseases, and most of these diseases, when we go into the in-depth studies, in-depth studies reveal most of these conditions are set thousands of years back by our acharyas. And I think this pariploida and this carcinoma is one such condition. And we are treating a lot of patients in our hospital, and here I would like to share a single case. Actually this was my first case, and this case is still following, and I'll share my experience with you. This patient aged 28 years, and she is a fashion designer by profession. She approached me complaining of lower abdominal pain, profuse foul smelling, yellowish discharge per vaginum, and with menstrual problem. And associated complaints included low back pain, burning micturition, dysmenorrhea and dyspareunia. And her onset was gradual, and it took 6 to 7 years. And regarding menstrual history, she had regular periods, but bleeding was profuse with clots and pain. She previously had one abortion, and on inspection, vulva was normal, discharge present, color was yellowish, and amount excessive, and odor offensive. And cervix was unhealthy and showed hypertrophy, and cervical motion tenderness was positive. And per vaginal examination, fornis is free, cervix firm, tenderness present, uterus was antiverted, and USG showed normal study. And this was the presentation. In this case, for subsiding this inflammation, I give gulujyadi kashaya, chandraprabha guliga, and gulgulu panchapala churna with honey and sharibadhyasava. Chandraprabha guliga I gave along with sharibadhyasava for 2 weeks, and after that I gave mahadikta kridam for 1 week. And I referred this case to Regional Cancer Center, Trivandrum. There, she did colposcopy, pap smear, and DNA test. And on colposcopy, visual inspection with acid medium was positive, and visual inspection with low-gold iodine was positive. And they diagnosed the case as HPV lesion with CIN2 changes. And pap smear showed inflammation with coilocytic atypia. And actually, as she went there, they did DNA test also, and they included her under their project. In this case, DNA test was positive for this oncogenic viral strains. And if it was not treated properly, this case would have definitely gone for invasive carcinoma. And they suggested LEEP for this patient. LEEP is loop electrical excision procedure. In LEEP procedure, a low voltage current will be passed through a copper wire and the abnormal cells will be removed. The treatment principle is Chedana Karma. This is applied in when the lesion is extensive. And she was posted for LEEP, and her as her this menstruation was imminent, and considering the blood loss, they gave 3 months time for her. Meantime, she again approached me, and I admitted her in our hospital, and it's Snehabana with Mahadikta Krida, Abhyanga with Pinda Taila, and Virejana with Ayubati Churna, Yoni Puranam with Mahadikta Krida, and Kshara Karma was done. And after this procedure, or this Shodhana Chikitsa, I gave Rasagandhi medical capsule for 1 month. And I advised her to follow this Pathya strictly to avoid too much intake of Kadu Amla, Lavana Rasa, Kshara Pradhana Ahara. She was in constant practice of daily intake of curd and pickles was there. And she was reviewed in RCC after 6 months, and it showed negative. VIM was negative, VLE was negative, Pap smear test was also negative. Now also she is continuing the investigations there. Last week also her Pap smear test showed negative result. And unlike modern medicine, our treatment varies from individual to individual. We have to assess doshyam, deshyam, balam, kalam, etc. before planning a treatment. And lot of medications in the form of kashayas, churnas, lehyas, etc., etc. are described by in our classical text. And we have to administer them judicially. And generally, we must adopt this Pitthala Yoni Vyabhak Chikitsa or Vadhika Yoni Vyabhak Chikitsa, Shobahara Chikitsa, Kushtahara Chikitsa, Krimihara Chikitsa, and Sthanika Chayak Chikitsa is also very important, like for this Yoni Puranam, Varthi, this Kshara Karma. Agni Karma also is effective. Actually, this our we are aiming this tissue, the cell destruction. So Agni Karma also we can adopt here. And so many Kashayas. Gulgurudikta Kashaya, Mahadikta Kashaya, Guluchadi Kashaya, and Asas. Arishtas are contraindicated because in most of the cases it is a Pitta Vada vitiated condition, but we can provide them with asavas like Sharibadi Asava, Chandana Asava, etc. Means Chandra Prabha Guliga, Kaishwara Gulgulu, and Kridas like Gulgurudikta Krida, Mahadikta Krida, etc. are found to be very effective. And Rasa preparations also we can consider, like Rasagandhi Medica and Rasa Sindhura. Churnas like Gulgulu Panjabala Churna and Pushyanila Churna. And actually this precancerous lesions, we'll get a long period for treating because early identification is the most important thing. By early detection, we can prevent the incidence of cervical cancer to a great extent. And it takes 15 to 20 years for this initial infection to become cancerous. So a long phase is there. So early detection is very important. And so many medicinal preparations are advised by our acharyas, and we can prescribe them very judicially by assessing all this dushyam, deshyam, balam, kalam, etc. And we can, Ayurveda can reduce the incidence of cervical cancer, which is the second most common genital tract malignancy among females in India. And Ayurveda holds an ocean of possibilities in curing HPV infection and related complications. Thank you.